Póngase la chumpa encima. Usted va a empezar a hacer bulla también.
Hello, hello, good evening, guys. Good evening, Ava. Good evening, Milagro. Hello, Doris. How are you?
Hi, teacher. Thank you. And you?
I'm okay. I'm like having a really nice day today. What about you, girls? Everything good?
Hello, teacher.
Hello, hello. I see also Silvia. Hello. Good evening. How are you? ¿Cómo estuvo su día? How was your day?
Cansado.
Oh, me imagino. I imagine. Pero ya es miércoles. Estamos en el corazoncito de la semana. Un poquito más y terminamos. Así que, you know, let's definitely get there. So let's get there. Okay. So, gracias a todos por conectarse. Hello there, Madeline. Good evening. Hello, hello. Silvia, hello. Good evening. Thank you for joining today's class. Nice to have you. And solo give me a quick second. Les escribo here. Okay. Okay, everybody. So, well, I'm so happy to have you all today. We are going to get started with class number 12. Okay, so ya vamos de bajada, right? So we are just in the middle of everything. Una semanita y media más, terminamos. Así que super nice job, right? Guys, how are you feeling? ¿Cómo se sienten en miércoles? ¿Ya de bajada también? Like, are you feeling all the way down? A little tired, ya cansados de la semana. Madeline, yes. how do you feel? Yeah, Doris. All right.
I feel tired.
A little tired, yes, I imagine. Pero, you know, ese sacrificio definitivamente va a valer la pena. It will pay off, all right? So thank you for your effort. Su fuerza es bien importante here y eso no podría ser posible sin ustedes. So thank you, everybody. Today is October the 7th, all right? And we are going to continue working with unit number 3. So for today, we have here present continuous versus a simple present that are part of the things that we are going to be working today with. Vamos a hacer un pequeño repaso de Simple Present. Algunas cositas que si ya se les olvidaron, we are going to describe them. Okay. And also, vamos a revisar Present Continuous, que lo comenzamos ayer. But today we are going to practice this a little more. I want you to take a look at the question that I have here. So I got this question. Give me a second. Okay, so I have this question right here that says, who is the first person to arrive at your workplace? Guys, ¿quién es la primera persona en llegar a su trabajo? Who is the first person?
My boss.
Your boss, okay. So, Ava, in your case, ¿quién es la primera persona? Who is the first person?
My boss.
Oh, your boss too. Okay, Milagro, in your case?
My boss.
Oh, okay, okay. So in every case, it's the boss. Okay, so take a look at this one. What is the first thing you do when you get to the workplace? Doris, what is the first thing you do?
My boss. Or me?
Yeah, you in your case.
Repeat the question, please.
Yes, la que está acá, miss, the one that is here. What is the first thing you do when you get to your workplace?
Okay. Clean my office.
Okay, you clean your office.
Yes.
okay, that's okay, that's good. También veo que se nos conecta Francisco. Hi, Francisco. Hi, Sandra. Thank you very much for joining. Fatima, hello. Good evening. Good evening, good evening, guys. Gracias por conectarse. Thank you for your time. So, guys, ¿qué es lo primero que hacen cuando llegan a su trabajo? What is the first thing you do when you get to your workplace?
I have breakfast.
Okay, you have breakfast. Nice, super good. You clean,
yes? No, I make my coffee.
Oh, you made your coffee. Okay. Guys, ¿y los demás? What about the rest?
Turn my computer.
Turn on the computer. Nice. Yeah. And the others?
I clean the table.
Okay. You clean the table. Uh-huh. And the others? I'm going to tell you a little secret. Como I was doing home office, you know, en otro lugar, in a different place. So, empiezo a trabajar a las 7. I started working at 7. So, I había agarrado la mala maña, as we said, okay, that me levantaba 5 minutos a las 7. I woke up 5 minutes to 7, and the first thing that I did was turn on my computer. But that's bad. Don't do that, okay? So take a shower, you know, do anything if you are doing home office, and then start working. So that is the first thing that you do. Ada, in your case, what do you do? What is the first activity that you do?
And the marcar, check the patients in the report. Checks the surgeries and programmation.
Ah, okay. So you check everything. Good. Fatima, and you?
I send emails.
You send emails. Okay. So maybe you turn on the computer, you send emails. Nice. Okay, everybody. Okay, that's very good. I have here a little conversation, okay? And I want your help, okay? I want you to help me with this little conversation that is about activities that we are doing at the moment. So let me see. Sometimes, no, let me see. Andres, hello, good evening. Avilan, hello. Isaac, hello, nice to have you today.
Good evening, teacher.
Hi. Okay, let me see. So let me have it between Andres, help me please. So Andres, ayúdeme con Ryan. Help me read the part of Ryan. And Avilene, ayúdeme porfa con Raúl. Help me read the part of Raúl.
De acuerdo, teacher.
Ready, Abilene? Good afternoon, Raul. What are you doing right now?
Good afternoon, Ryan. Well, I am planning a video conference.
Oh, the conference with the new team in San Salvador. What is our team doing right now?
Yes, it is. They are getting ready for the conference in the meeting room.
I see. What time do you usually get to your workplace? What's the first thing you do?
I usually arrive at 6:30 a.m. And the first thing I do is to check my email. And you?
Well, I arrive at 7 or 7:30. It depends on traffic. My first activity is to pick up the litter.
Yes, very good pronunciation, very good intonation. That was nice, guys. Now, I have a question for you. What time do you arrive to work? Okay, and what is the first thing that you do? So, veamos la respuesta. The person says here, I usually arrive at 6:30, or I arrive at 7:30. It depends on traffic. My first activity is to pick up the letters, okay? So guys, what time do you arrive to your workplace? What time do you arrive? Milagro, what time do you arrive to your workplace?
Dice que a las 6:30
a.m. Yes, ese es un ejemplo. This is an example. And you, what about you, Milagro? What time do you arrive?
I arrive 8 a.m.
8 a.m. Okay, very good. Thank you so much. Let me ask Francisco. Francisco, what time do you arrive to your workplace?
7:30.
7:30. And you said the first thing you do is turn on the computer, right?
Yes, yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you, thank you. Andres, what about you? What time do you arrive to your workplace and what is the first activity you do?
I arrive at 8:30. It depends on traffic. And first activity is on a PC and order the office and prepare a cup of coffee.
Okay, thank you. Very nice and very, very descriptive. Yes, of course. Coffee
toda
is
la descripción.
Yeah, but super nice. Nice, nice. Okay, Christian, what about you, Christian? What time do you arrive to your workplace and what is the first activity you
do? I arrive at 7:30 and the first activity is I turn the computer.
Okay, very good. So everybody works with the computer. Mm-hmm. Sandra, what about you? What time do you arrive? Are you doing home office, Sandra? Sandra Patricia? Are you doing home office?
Homework.
I mean, like home office, si se queda en la casa, are you doing home office?
Yes.
O está yendo a?
Yes. Home.
Okay, so.
Uh-huh.
And so home. You're at home. Mm-hmm. So, okay. What time do you arrive? No vale porque ahí está en su casa, but. Okay, what is the first thing that you do? Cuando se despierta y empieza a trabajar, what is the first thing that you do?
At 7 a.m.
So at 7 a.m., you start working.
Yes.
Okay. And I got a question. Yeah. What time do you get up?
Oh. At 6:30 a.m.
Okay. but you take a shower and everything.
Yeah.
Ah, very nice, very nice. Okay, guys, ¿quién más está haciendo home office? Who is doing home office? Nadie más trabaja desde la casa ahorita. Nobody else is doing home office. No. Okay. So it's only Sandra and I. Okay. Okay, everybody. So we are. You got to work. Anyways. So, let's take a look at some of these questions. Veamos la primera. It says, what are you doing right now? ¿Qué me está preguntando? ¿Qué quieres saber? Good afternoon, Raúl. What are you doing right now? ¿De qué se trata la pregunta?
¿Qué está haciendo ahora?
Ahorita, en este momento. Guys, what are you doing right now? I am planning a video conference. I am talking. I am listening to you. What are you doing? Guys, are you paying attention?
Yes.
Okay. Or are you watching TV?
No.
No.
No? Are you eating? No? Nobody's eating?
I play attention and watch TV.
Oh,
sometimes.
Or the cell phone. Are you checking your cell phone?
No, receiving the class in cell phone.
Ah, you are very good students. Nice. So, cuando describimos lo que hacen ahorita, we can use this question. Hey, what are you doing right now? Yeah, Harrison, what are you doing right now?
And now I watch my screen with the classroom.
Ah, okay, so I'm watching, exactly. I'm paying attention, I'm listening. So, yeah, very good. So take a look at this one. What is your team doing? Pero la pregunta es right now. Ayer vimos cómo indicar hacia futuro, si se recuerdan. Tomorrow, next week. Pero esta pregunta es de ahorita. What are you doing right now? What is your team doing right now? Yes. And then tenemos otras preguntas, for example, what time do you usually get to work? So everybody, vamos a practicar. We are going to practice. Pero antes de eso, voy a pasar asistencia, like super quick. So solo si me ayuda con your camera. Y me dicen present when I say your name. Casi estamos completos. Very nice. Gracias a todos por la super, super attendance. Super punctuality, super nice. Estamos casi completos. We are nicely doing this. Okay, let me go over. Ahora es 7. Today is the 7th. So, Fatima Lopez?
Present teacher.
Thank you very much. Ava Azucena?
Present teacher.
Thank you. Thank you, Azucena. Guillermo? Not yet. Christian?
Present, present.
Thank you, Christian. Isaac?
Yeah.
Present.
Thank you. Luz?
Present, teacher.
Nice, Luz. Thank you very much. Avilen?
Present, teacher.
It's Avilen, ¿verdad? No, Avilene.
Avilene.
Avilene. Ah, okay. Elizabeth, better. Sandra Patricia. Sandra Patricia.
Present.
Thank you, Sandra. Edith Trigueros.
Present.
Todavía no. Silvia Girón.
Present.
Gracias, Silvia. Francisco Eduardo. Sí, ¿verdad? Por ahí estábamos.
Present.
Thank you, Francisco. Sandra Beatriz.
Yeah.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Sandra. Gerson David.
Present.
Thank you. Madeline Gabriela.
Present.
Oh, Gaby. Verónica Yesenia. Oh, creo que ella escribió que
present.
Estaba en camino. Ya ¡ay, vino. Ya vino! Gracias, Miss. ¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo le fue? ¿Estaba feo el tráfico?
Sí, sí.
Imagino, ya está lloviendo. Pero gracias, Miss, por conectarse siempre y estar acá. I got Doris.
Present.
Doris, super, super punctual, always. Thank you, Doris. Milagro también, right? Milagro.
Present.
Thank you so much. Jennifer Hueso. Todavía no. Andrés, ya estamos ready, right?
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Andrés. And Cesar, ¿ya estamos por acá, Cesar? Todavía no, not yet. Okay. Okay, everybody, thank you very so much. Give me one second. Okay, everybody, so vamos a practicar. We are going to practice this conversation. Remember, estas conversaciones están en su material, so you can take a picture o descargan el material y la revisan ahí, right? So let's take a look if you need. Tome la captura. You can take a picture of this one. Okay. And let's start practicing. Let's get ready. I'm going to make some groups here and practice this as much as possible. Siempre cambiémosle la información. Por ejemplo, si dice, hey, what's your name? Good afternoon, Raúl. No hay ningún Raúl. Good afternoon, Silvia. Good evening, Silvia. Good evening, Milagro. Good morning, Fátima. So cambiémosle, right? Y intentemos hacer lo más real posible. So, everybody, let's get started now. Let's go, go, go. Let's join it.
Hello, compañeros.
Hello, Isabel.
Good night. What are you doing right now?
Silvia.
Me escucha, ¿no?
Silvia, hagámoslo,
sí.
Hagámoslo entonces nosotros dos. Si quieres, empieza ya.
Espera.
Hola.
¿Me escucha?
Ahí está ya.
Sí, va. Empecemos de nuevo.
Hola, sí.
Hello, Isaac. Good evening. What are you doing right now?
Good evening, Silvia. I am planning a video conference.
Oh, the conference with the new team in San Salvador. What is our team doing right now?
Yes, it is. They are getting ready for the conference in the meeting room.
I see. What time do you usually get to your workplace? What's the first thing you do?
I usually arrive at 6:30 a.m. and the first thing I do is to check my email. And you?
Well, I arrive at 7 or 7:30. It depended on traffic. My first activity is to pick up the letters.
Ahora, Sandrita, ¿me escucha? Sandra.
Yes.
Ahora hagámoslo. Yo empiezo y usted sigue.
Okay.
Good evening, Sandra. What are you doing right now?
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, Milagro. Well, I am playing a video conference.
Oh, the conference with the new team in San Salvador. What is your team doing right now?
Yes, it is. They are getting ready for the conference in the meeting room.
Y luego thanks for asking me. And
yes, I am good. No, podemos poner.
Yeah, good. Thanks for asking me.
Podemos. Ese what are you doing, podemos ponerlo después si querés.
Ah, como. Ajá, va. Chévere. Como ahorita, después de. Thanks for asking.
Como ahorita después. Porque te voy a decir yo. ¿Cómo se llama? How are you? Te voy a poner yo.
I'm fine.
¿Y por qué no hacemos unas cosas, chicos? Los cuatro primeros arriba, sean ustedes dos, los tres primeros, perdón. Y los cuatro de abajo lo hacemos con Avilene. Como aquí ¿cómo? La participación es de Ryan y Raúl, ¿verdad?
Ajá.
¿Qué les parece?
Sí, igual, ajá, está bien.
Igual, ajá, lo mismo.
Aquí porque vamos a hacer una sola conversación.
Una sola conversación y nosotros con las actividades habituales que nosotros tenemos, pero.
Que nos preguntan a cada uno.
Y después, cabal, nosotros hacemos como la introducción para que ya sea Gerson o yo.
Para entrar al tema.
Entremos en el tema y los incluimos a ustedes después, o nos incluyen a nosotros ustedes. O sea,
ajá. Exactamente.
Va, excelente.
Entonces.
What? Va, entonces estaba así. ¿A dónde habíamos quedado?
And thanks for asking me. And
how are you?
And how are you, Christian?
I'm fine. Entonces, Harrison, what are you doing?
Ajá, exacto. How are you doing right now? What are you doing?
Harrison dice, I am watching TV series.
TV series.
In Netflix.
Netflix.
His name, her. The series name.
Good afternoon. Llega hasta las 6.
Mm-hmm. Teacher también.
And at 6 p.m. at 9 p.m. is good evening.
Teacher, estamos deliberando.
Good evening.
Y good night.
Yes, tell me.
¿Cuándo ocupamos good night?
¿Cuándo nos vamos?
No es por hora.
No.
Cuando vamos a dormir.
Es función, exactly. Es una función. Okay. Like, for example, good evening es cuando yo llego a un lugar y le digo, hey, good evening, everyone. Pero cuando yo ya me voy, cuando yo me retiro de una casa, me voy a dormir, I tell you, hey, good night. Cuando nos vamos, por ejemplo, it's like, hey, bye-bye, everyone, good night. Llego, good evening. Okay. Me voy, good night. Yes.
¿Siempre para un saludo o good evening? Okay.
Yeah, si es un saludo, yes. Si es un adiós, good night.
Nosotros lo habían explicado de otra forma, teacher.
¿Qué por hora?
Ajá. No. De, así como por tiempo. That's that 6 and 9 is good evening.
The other probablemente night, la diferencia. Yes, but no. Lo que sucede es que por lo general usted se despide ya en la noche, right? Mm-hmm. Después de las 10 de la noche se dice bye bye. Pero no, en realidad es la función. So llego, good evening. Me voy, good night. Ajá. Uh-huh. Okay. So we use it that way.
Uh-huh. Okay. Very good.
Okay.
Thanks, teacher.
Continue.
You're so welcome.
Ada.
I haven't to see. Yo iba a poner eso. I haven't to see.
Dale, entonces, dale, ponelo.
I haven't to see.
Watch.
On weekend.
Weekend.
I haven't. O sea, como yo tengo que verla el fin de semana.
Ajá, está bien.
I haven't to see. On weekend.
And Luz, do you like, podemos interactuar con ella, and you lose.
Entonces, and tú puedes preguntarle, ahí, mira, Gerson, como...
¿Cuál sería la que le gusta?
No, oh. O... No.
My first activity is to the letters.
Sí. Ya siento un poco más fluido.
Ya como que se nos está saltando un poquito la lengua, teacher.
Eso, I'm so happy to hear that. No, desde hace varios días, you know, so nice. Very nice. Okay, guys, did you finish with the practice? Do you need more time?
Sí, ya lo hicimos de varias formas.
Okay, so let's go back just for 1-2 minutes. Thank you very much. Vamos a darle un minutito for the others to come back. So we are going to wait for everybody to be here. We got 7. We are more. Okay, everyone, so thank you very much. I'm very happy that most of you already got this thing going. So ya tienen más confianza, ya se soltaron, you know, you start talking. Excellent job. Eso es lo más importante, que se confíen what you're doing. So I would like to have maybe one volunteer, one pair, okay, or two pairs. So I don't know if I have like any volunteer. Or victims? I like both. Milagro! Yes, Milagro. Nice. Okay. Milagro, select your partner. ¿Quién va a ser su compañero? Who is going to be your partner?
Isaac.
Isaac, very nice. Let's get going, guys. Yes.
Good evening, Isaac. What are you doing right now?
Good evening, Milagro. Well, I am planning a video conference.
Oh, the conference with the new team in San Salvador. What is our team doing right now?
Yes, it is. They are getting ready for the conference in the meeting room.
I see. What time do you usually get to your workplace? What if 15 you do?
de jugar, ¿verdad?
I usually arrive at 6:30 a.m. and the first thing I do is to check my emails. And you?
Well, I arrive at 7 or 7:30 in depends on traffic. My first activity is to pick up the letters.
Yes, excellent. Very good job. That was nice, guys. That was nice. Okay. So, very good job. Very good pronunciation. That was very fluent. Tengo otro pair, volunteer, que sea diferente, that you have made your own conversation.
Teacher.
Yes, yeah, Silvia.
¿Cómo se pronuncia? To pick up or pick up?
To pick up. To pick up the letters. Pick up.
Uh-huh. Okay.
To pick up the letters, yes. Silvia, help me, help me. Okay, so help me, Silvia, please. Let's get a conversation going. Si tienen una que ustedes hayan creado, muchísimo mejor, even better. So seleccione a su pair, select your partner.
It's the same.
The same conversation.
Yes.
We have a other conversation.
Perfect. Let's go for it. Nice. Thank you, Herson.
My group is Christian, Adeline, and Luz, and me. Okay. Christian, start, please.
Okay, okay. Hi, Herson. Good afternoon. How are you?
Hello, Christian. I am good. Thanks for asking me. How are you?
Okay, Herson, I'm fine. And what are you doing right now?
I am watching TV and a series in Netflix. The series name is Cobra Kai. I recommend you watch this series.
Oh, nice, Herson. I happen to see this series on Saturday night.
And you, Luz, and Adeline, what are you planning in this weekend? Luz?
Microfono.
Luz, microfono, Luz. I'm sorry. Hi, Herson. Good night. I'm going to visit my family on Saturday, and on Sunday I go to a group activity.
I am watching TV. My favorite series is The Walking Dead. I do draw and dance practices. Doing visit and my family.
Okay, good plans for you this weekend. It's all, teacher.
That's yes, it. Thank you, guys. Very nice. That was good. Luz, excellent job. That was very nice. Evelyn, I like your plans. Christian, Herson, that was very nice. Very good fluency, very good pronunciation. Good job, guys. Nice. Okay. So we are talking about the activities that you are doing right now y también en la semana. So let's continue. And I have a little exercise for you that is about vocabulary. So I created this for you with the vocabulary that we are going to practice today. Okay? You have here some words, and here you have like the sentences. Okay? So what you have to do, guys, what you have to do is select, okay, the word that fits into the place. For example, I don't pick up, I don't hand in, I don't type, I don't arrange, or I don't take care. So vamos a seleccionar una. We are going to select one word that describes each space the best. Okay, I will give you like 3-4 minutes. Si hay alguna palabra que no sepan qué significa, you can check your dictionary, you can take a look, and to get more vocabulary, right? So let's go for this.
No te conectaste.
En the first one, el I que está después de because I my finger. No está de más.
Déjeme ver la primera. I don't. Oh, sorry. Yes, you are right. Hold on. Es un typo. Es un error de dedo. So. Ah, wait. Wait. Wait.
Wait. Finger.
Wait. No vean la respuesta. Don't see the answer. I show you the answer.
No, see, teacher. No, see, teacher.
Ah, oh, okay. Yeah, please close your, close your eyes. I show you the answers. Okay, guys. So, yeah, but you're right, Harrison. Olvidé que estaba ahí la respuesta. Okay. So, yes, omitan el I. This was my mistake. So, I don't because my finger, okay, omitan el I. Let me know when you are ready or if you need more time. So, also let me know. Let me know when you are ready, guys. Si necesitan más tiempo, also tell me. Thank you very much. Anybody else?
Don't, teacher.
Thank you, Doris.
Don't, teacher.
Okay, everybody, so help me please with the answers that we have right here. La primera, the first one says pick up. So where can we use pick up? What is the sentence?
Please pick up the letters for me.
Pick up the letters.
Yes.
Okay. Pick up the letters. All right. Thank you. Do you have the same? Do you have a different answer?
Please pick up my on my pen with my pet. I'm going out of the city.
Please pick up my pets. I'm going out of the city. All right. That's a possibility as well. We will check the answer.
Please take care of my pets. I am going out of the city.
Oh, so please take care of my pets. All right. Okay. Let's take a look at Handin. What about Handin?
It's so late. I need to hand the letters
for me.
Okay, so Madeline, what was your answer?
It's so late. I need to hand in the report on time.
Okay, thank you. Harrison, what is yours?
Please hand in the letters for me.
Hand in the letters for me. Okay, we will check that in a second. What about typing? What do you have in typing? What is the sentence?
I don't hand in because my finger is broken.
Because my finger is broken. All right, in arrange?
I have to arrange meeting for Monday.
Okay, so let me show you. The first one, pick up. So pick up, the answer is...
So late.
Please pick up the letters for me. Okay, so please pick up, okay? Get the letters for me. Hand in, let's take a look. It's so late, I need to hand in the report some time. Okay, nice. Type is? I don't type because my finger is broken. Very good. Arrange, let's take a look. I have to arrange, yes, meetings for Monday, excellent. And take care, please take care of my pets. I'm going out of the city. All right, guys, lo tenemos así. Do you have something like this?
No.
Yeah.
Yes. So.
Estaba escuchando la oración de Gerson y tiene un poco de sentido.
De hecho, dice, sí.
It's so late. I need to pick up the report on time.
Actually, yes. You know, now that I listen to, I think, Christian. También hay Christian. Also, I was listening to Christians.
I was feeling down. But right now, I feel good.
Escuché que alguien me decía, please pick up of my pet.
The pet.
Casi. That was like pretty close. Solamente quizás sin el of. Please pick up my pet. So that sería, tendría sentido as well. It makes a lot of sense. Or please. Tell me.
The other version.
Yeah, tell me.
I don't pick up because my finger is broken. Tiene que levantar algo y
agarrar algo porque si no está quebrada.
It makes sense. Solo que quizás necesitaríamos algo más. Por ejemplo, I don't pick up, pero sería como el qué. I don't pick up the pencil, I don't pick up the paper. The boxes, exactly. Quizás sí, tendría como un poquito más de contexto, tendría sentido. Yeah, you're totally right, tendría sentido. But in this case, por el contexto, la que está como más cerca es like type, right? I don't type. I can't type, no puedo. I can't type because my finger is broken. So olvidémonos de like, okay? Nice job. Okay, everybody. So that was the vocabulary for today. Ya vamos a usarlo. We are going to use these. So help me arrange the sentences. I have to arrange meetings for Monday. I have to arrange a party. Okay? Take care. ¿Me dan otro ejemplo con take care? Give me another example with take care. Take care. The example here says, please take care of my pets. I'm going out of the city. I'm going out of my house. So, deme otro ejemplo. Give me another example with take care.
Please take care to my brother.
Exactly. Please take care of my brother. My brother is sick. My brother has a fever. Mm-hmm. Another example?
No. Please take care of my house. I go to the beach.
Yes, very good.
Cuando uno le dice al vecino. Anda, le dice al vecino. Hey, ahí me cuida la casa.
Exactly. maybe he has. Exactly. Please take care of my house. Yes, very good. O cuando usted se despide y usted le dice a alguien, hey, bye-bye, take care. Cuídate, cuídese. So take care. Mm-hmm. Very nice. So that's a word. Handin. ¿Qué encontraron por handin? What is handin? What did you find for handin? The example. Okay, the example says it's so late. I need to hand in the report on time. So, ¿qué más pueden entregar? What can you hand in?
Yo había puesto yes. Please hand in the letters for me.
Excellent. Please hand in the hand in the letters for me. Yes, that makes sense. That definitely makes sense. Thank you, Cesar. Hand in the letters, hand in la tarea, please hand in the homework. Okay, so son cosas que entregamos, right? So hand in. Okay, guys, let's move on a little bit and I have some questions for you. There are only like two questions here. It says get in pairs and discuss the following questions. Who gets earlier at the workplace? So, ¿quién de ustedes llega más temprano? Porque, ¿qué hace? En every detail, y pueden compartir todos los detalles. Every detail you can share. What is the topic Raúl and his team are discussing in the conference? Si se recuerdan de la conversación, if you remember the conversation, they were talking about something. So, what is the topic? What is the topic? ¿De qué están hablando? What are they discussing in the conference? Solo para tener una idea general, la palabra discussing no es en español discutir, solamente es como hablar. So what are they discussing in the conference? ¿De qué están hablando? All right? So with this being said, guys, vamos a trabajar en grupo. Solo son 5 minutitos. I will ask you to join the groups for 5 minutes. Talk to them, all right, practice with them, answer the questions. Especialmente, demos detalle de la número uno, who gets to work early. Si no son ustedes, if it is your boss, ¿por qué llega tan temprano? ¿Qué hace? What does your boss do in the super early in the morning, etc.? So 5 minutes, a las 59, I will bring you back. So listen to your classmates and let's go.
My activity is
Girls, solo si me ayudan, please, a entrar a la reunión. ¿Me confirma si les cayó la invitación, please?
Teacher.
Hola, Miss.
¿Me puede enviar a un grupo, por favor?
Ah, vaya, perfecto. No, no le apareció, Miss.
Pues que por quererla apartar para copiar la oración,
la cerró.
Se me desapareció.
Ah, vaya, no se preocupe. Ahorita le mando la invitación. ¿Me confirma si la ve?
No.
No le parece.
No.
¿Ve su foto? ¿Ve su foto, Milagro? ¿Ve su pantalla?
No, no tampoco.
Vale, le voy a dejar de compartir la mía y me confirma si se ve usted.
Ahora sí me veo. Vale. Hoy sí me veo.
¿Ve los puntitos en la parte superior de su imagen? Como acá, cabal, esa parte.
Ah, sí, sí, sí. Vale,
dele
sí.
Clic ahí, porfa. Ve algo okay. Que dice grupos, breakout rooms.
No dice eso.
¿Qué
dice?
Dice
stop video, rename, pin video, high cell view. Eso lo dice.
High cell view. No le aparece grupos.
Stop, dice stop video, rename, pin video y high cell view.
High cell view. No, qué raro que no le aparezca. Le voy a enviar nuevamente la invitación. Déjeme ver si la puedo enviar directo. Deme un segundito. Give me just a second here. So, Milagro, try one more time. Ok, tendría que aparecerle. It should be like pushing there. Se la acabo de mandar, Miss. Solo me confirma si le aparece.
No, pues me dice lo mismo. Dice mute a la par y al lado están los tres puntitos.
Y en los,
y si
tres,
le doy a los tres puntitos. En los tres puntitos me aparece eso. Dice mute my audio. Stop video. Rename. Pin video y hide cell view.
Dale clic en High Self View.
Ahorita. Me desaparecí.
Ok, no se ve.
No, solo aparece usted en la
yo
pantalla.
Sí la veo, entonces usted se oculta, qué raro. Super weird. Vale, pero no se preocupe, igual el tiempo que les brinda fueron solamente 5 minutos and time is over. Así que ahorita regresan, they are coming back. Si gusta, solamente veamos las preguntas. Let's take a look at the questions. Question number one is who gets earlier at the workplace? ¿Dónde usted trabaja, Milagro? In the place where you work, who gets earlier? ¿Quién llega temprano? Who gets earlier?
My husband.
Your husband. What time does he get to work?
Perdón, teacher.
What time does your husband get?
My husband, ¿cómo digo llega?
Arrives.
Right.
Arrives.
Arrives.
Mm-hmm.
At 5 a.m.
Wow, that's super early.
Yes.
Okay, and you?
8 a.m.
Ah, okay. So it's a different time. But I mean, it's okay. It's fine. Okay. Now let's discuss question number two. What is the topic Raul and his team are discussing in the conference?
Es que no sé qué quiere decir esa pregunta, teacher.
¿Se recuerda de la conversación? Do you remember the conversation?
Sí.
Okay. So, in the conversation, ¿de qué estaban hablando? What is the topic they were discussing in the conference?
Ahorita la estoy mirando.
Vaya,
bueno, están hablando aquí a qué horas llegan a su trabajo.
Uh-huh.
¿Están planificando una videoconferencia?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Y bueno, se preguntan qué es lo que hacen al llegar.
Yes.
Y la hora que llegan a su trabajo.
Mm-hmm. Exactly, exactly. Very good. Yes, so eso es el tema. That is the topic they are talking about. Very good. Thank you, Milagro.
Discussing, mm-hmm. ¿Qué es esa palabra?
Discussing is talking.
Discussing.
Yes, discuss. So, for example, si le decimos, hey, please, everybody, discuss about this topic. Discuss no es peleen, right? Discuss es hablen, ajá, like socialicen este tema. So, discuss this topic.
Como, pero dijo que no era discutir, ¿verdad?
No es discutir en el sentido de pelear, you know, de establecer algo o una posición, sino solamente discuss es hablen. Compartan opiniones. That is the idea of discuss.
Okay. That is, o sea, comparten opiniones en la conferencia.
Mm-hmm. Yes, algo what are así. They discussing? ¿De qué hablan? It's personal. Yes. ¿Escuché un teacher?
Sí, teacher. Entonces, hi. Topic es sobre lo que están hablando ellos.
Yes, exactly. Topic es el tema, como el tema principal. Yes. Okay. So, what is the topic, guys? What is the topic that Raúl and his team are discussing in the conference? ¿De qué están hablando ellos? What is the topic?
Uh-huh.
¿De qué estaban hablando? Do you remember?
The meeting.
Que estaban planning a video conference.
Yes, they are planning a video conference. Uh-huh.
Del arriving the work.
What time do they arrive to work? Yes.
Arrive to work.
Mm-hmm.
The first activity.
And the activities. Okay.
In the work.
The first activity. Very good. The first activity they do in the workplace. Yes. Thank you very much. Okay. Excellent. Very good job. Give me just a second. It's, oh my goodness, ya son las 9, it's 9 p.m. No sentido, I haven't felt the time. So, déjenme like go over the second control of attendance. Por quienes me hacían falta still. Creo que estamos completos. Nice job, everyone. So, teníamos días de no tener full house. I'm so happy, I guess everybody's here. So I got Guillermo. Guillermo ya está por acá, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, estaba. Where is Guillermo? Hey, Guillermo. Good evening. Thank you, Guillermo. Thank you so much for joining today. I got Edith. Creo que por ahí vi a Edith también.
Hello.
Hello. How are you?
Hi.
Thank you so much, Edith, for joining. I got Jennifer.
Hello, good evening.
Hi, Jennifer. Thank you so much for joining. I hope you are super, super good. So let me just mark you here. And I got Cesar. Si ya lo escuchas un ratito, right, Cesar? Thank you, yes. Cesar. Thank you so much. Yes, we got full house. Good, everybody. Les mando un dulce virtual in some minutes. Excellent job. We got full house today.
Thanks.
All right, everybody. So let's move on with this. We are going to practice today the differences between this present simple and present continuous. Let me share my screen and let's go for the next activity. So, let me hold on. Okay. So this is the differences, okay, these are the differences between simple present and present continuous. It's a simple present. Primero, vamos a identificar qué es un simple present. This is that we use simple present for general information, routine, and activities. Y tenemos un par de ejemplos, all right? Sandra, Patricia, please, ayúdame a leer los ejemplos del simple present.
Okay. I check my email every morning. Two, He writes reports about meeting. Three, she audits inventories. And four, they arrange meeting.
Perfect. Thank you very much. Cesar, ayúdame con los ejemplos de present continuous. We use present continuous for ongoing activities at the time of speaking. Ayer veíamos que también para futuro, right? So, ¿qué es present continuous? El ing, ing, all right? Cesar, me ayuda con los ejemplos, please.
Okay, teacher. I am planning a video conference. They are getting the documents ready. She is editing the information. The secretary is making a phone call.
Thank you very much. Yes. All right, guys. So tell me, please, ¿cuáles son las diferencias que ven de simple present a present continuous? Cualquier diferencia is welcome. Tell me.
Para el presente continuo se usa el verb be.
Uh-huh.
Y para el simple present, no. Es un verbo en infinitivo el que ocupamos.
Okay, thank you. Anybody else? ¿Alguien más? Cualquier diferencia que vean, any difference is welcome. Silvia?
An ing of the verb.
Okay, ing, yes. In present continuous, we use ing. Very good. ¿Algo más? ¿Algo que hayan notado? Anything?
In present continuous, use the verb to be.
We use verb to be, seguido de el ing que nos mencionaba Silvia. Very nice. Yes, yes, yes. Okay. ¿Algo más? Anything else?
Creo que en el,
díganos,
el ing va aplicado al final y en el continuo va en, al principio.
Al principio.
El verbo.
Por acá, como por morning en meeting.
Correcto. Por ejemplo, morning al final, meeting, cabal. Y en el continuo dice planning al, después del I am. Y después del they are va el ing del game.
Gotcha. Okay, thank you, Luz. Es bien importante lo que dice Luz, y vamos a revisar algo acá. Los verbos, remember that los verbos son acciones, right? Cuando usted dice, estoy comiendo, okay, me estoy bañando, no me molestas, okay? Eso es present continuous. Entonces significa que a una acción, es decir, a un verbo, yo le voy a agregar ing. Meeting puede ser un verbo. Por ejemplo, I am meeting my friend. Yo me estoy reuniendo. Pero en este contexto, si ustedes revisan, el verbo es writes. Meeting, entonces, no es un verbo en sí, sino la palabra reunión. All right? Es un poquito diferente. En la estructura sí, pareciera como si el ing fuera al final, pero estos no son verbos, solamente son como las palabras. Pero es bien interesante considerarlo, ¿verdad? So, let's be careful with this. Morning, si lleva ing y se puede confundir, pero morning no es un verbo, solamente es como la palabra que ya es así, right? Morning, meeting, so ya son palabras tal cual, como la veíamos ayer con shopping, so, right? Porque podemos a veces confundirlos un poquito. So, ¿qué más vamos a considerar del simple present y del present continuous? Las palabras de enlace que utilizamos. For example, si yo hablo de rutinas, ¿qué palabras normalmente uso para mi rutina? Every day, every morning, always. ¿Qué más?
Tomorrow.
Can you repeat?
Tomorrow.
Next.
Pero, no.
Pero tomorrow no sería una rutina porque sería hasta mañana. Sería en present continuous. Sometimes, yes. Sometimes.
Always.
Never.
Usually.
Yes.
Always.
Seldom.
Hardly ever. Seldom.
Hardly ever.
Ellos son rutinas. Y si yo quiero hablar de ahorita, ¿cuál palabra veíamos que es para ahorita? Right. ¿Se recuerdan?
Right now.
Exactly. Right now. ¿Y si es de mañana?
Tomorrow.
Next Monday, next Tuesday, next month. Exactly.
So, next week.
next week. Very good. Entonces, esa es la diferencia. Y vamos a identificar here este ejercicio. All right. It says, complete the sentences in present continuous. Todas, si ustedes se fijan, todas ellas, everything is present continuous. Pero ya vamos a ver un par de ejercicios donde los vamos a combinar y vamos a identificar what is the correct answer. So, le voy a dar un par de minutitos. I'll give you some minutes. Individualmente, try to answer. You can write it. Pueden escribirles. Si quieren revisarlas, pueden escribirlas in the chat as well. All right. And I will pay attention to them. So, I'll give you 5 minutes. Complete the sentences in present continuous. Esas solo son present continuous.
Thank you.
Thank you, Cesar. Nice, nice, nice. That was quick. That was very fast.
Finish.
Thank you. Oh, guys, that was easy. That was a piece of cake for you. Okay, good, good, good. Okay, good, good. Okay. So yes, I'll give you 1 more minute para que todos terminen. So everybody is doing it. Okay, everybody, so let's take a look at the exercise here. La primera dice, Thomas is printing out the contract, okay? Number two, ¿quién tiene la segunda? Who's got number two? Tom, Cheryl?
Cheryl is meeting with the boss right now.
Cheryl is meeting. Very good. Exactly. So number two, I'm gonna write it in the chat, is meeting. Number two is meeting. Number three, what about number three?
He's taking care.
Pero me le falta algo. He
is taking care.
He is taking care, exactly. Remember, no solamente he taking care, sino es necesario, es súper, súper importante, he is taking care. Porque en lo contrario, en español diríamos él tomando, él cuidando, and it's él está cuidando, right? Number four, let's take a look at that one.
I am paying attention.
Excellent, I'm paying attention. Number five,
She is preparing
the briefing, like a short meeting. In number six,
they are sending the products to the warehouse.
Very good job. ¿Todos tienen algo similar? Do you have the same?
Yes.
Teacher, yes. I have a question.
Yes,
en la número tres tengo... No me fijé cómo la escribió.
Está en el... está en el chat, Milagro. O del chat me dice usted.
Ah.
No.
Ya, ya la encontré, gracias.
Ok, ok, you're welcome. Están en el chat. Sí, se las compartí para que ustedes revisen también spelling. So, he is taking care. Ok, everybody. So, I got some questions for you. Y vamos a revisar, like, right now, some of the possibilities here. The siguiente activity says, write in the boxes the activities you usually do on a Monday morning. Ok. So, I will give you 3 minutes. Hagamos un listado de lo que ustedes hacen every Monday morning, please. What do you do every Monday morning? I'll give you like 2 or 3 minutes. Están, dice que boxes, okay, pero en realidad es como en su cuaderno. Yeah, it's on your notebook. So only writing the in your notebook activities that you usually do on a Monday morning. Algo bien importante, pongámosle atención acá. Dice usually, ok. Significa que es simple present. Por lo tanto, no me le van a agregar ing. Entonces, no le ponemos ing, ok. Be careful with that. So, 3 minutos. I'll give you 3 minutes.
Y en cada cuadrito vamos a poner una actividad.
No, no, Miss. Yo sé que acá dice, bueno, si tiene su material, si lo tiene impreso, puede hacerlo perfectamente, no hay problema. Pero eso es como, porque el material está impreso y es así. But, de lo contrario, en el cuaderno, do it on your notebook, una lista está bien. A list is good. Claro que se sienten cómodos hacer como los cuadritos y escribirlo. No hay ningún problema. It's definitely up to you. Okay, guys, so please give me verbal confirmation when you finish.
Done.
Thank you very much.
Finish, teacher.
Okay, very good. Okay, guys, now tell me, please, some of your Monday Monday morning activities. So let me listen to some of you. Madeline, tell me one activity, please. What do you do on a Monday morning?
I pray in my bed.
Very nice. Thank you. I have to start doing it. I don't do it very often. Okay, thank you. I got, let me see. Avilén, tell me one activity. What do you do on a Monday morning?
I attend customers. I do update inventory.
Continue.
I check reports to sell weekends.
Okay, thank you very much. Guillermo, what about you? What do you do?
In the Monday, I get up early.
Okay.
Take my car.
Okay.
and I turn on my PC.
Okay.
I check my mail.
All right.
Program.
All right.
Check the pending diagnostic.
Ah, okay. Okay. Of the machines.
Son diagnósticos pendientes que quedan para probar.
Oh, okay. So you approve the diagnostic. Yeah. Ah, okay, okay. So yo pensaba que usted hacía el diagnóstico. You approve them. Okay, thank you, very nice. Good job, everybody, good job. Now, combinemos, let's combine them. Let's take a look at the following questions, okay? And here, tenemos ambas, we got everything, okay? Question number one says, what are you doing tomorrow? Yeah. So what are you doing tomorrow, guys? Next one. Oh, sorry, se me fue algo acá. What do you do during the weekend, all right? So what do you do during the weekend? And what, where are you going? Where are you going on vacation? Where are you going tomorrow? So first, let's take a look at these sentences. Estamos combinando ambas cosas, okay? Si les pregunto, hey guys, what are you doing tomorrow? Denme un ejemplo, ¿qué responderían? What can you answer? Dice tomorrow.
Wake up at 6 a.m.
Pero completo, like, the complete sentence. Tell me the full. Sujeto, verbo, complemento. The full sentence.
I am playing with my...
I am take a shower at 6 a.m. tomorrow.
Oh, okay, very good, very, very nice, Andres. Pero me le falta algo, me le falta something super small. I am
taking.
Yes, I am taking. Very good. Guillermo, what are you doing tomorrow?
I am playing with my friends.
Very good. Okay, so remember, what are you doing tomorrow? Como acá dice, doing, entonces es futuro, voy a usar ing con todos los verbos. I am playing, I am reading, I am studying. What do you do during the weekend? Ay, look, estoy usando do. What do you do during the weekend? Give me one example, please.
What the meaning of during?
Durante. What durante. Do you do during the weekend?
Pero durante la semana.
It's confused because during is NG.
Yes, I know. Okay. Let me make it easier. What do you do?
I am playing
in the weekend.
With my son in the park.
Okay, so let's take a look at this. What do you do in the weekend? All right. So, Edith, I believe she says that she plays in the park. So, vamos a revisar esto. What do you do? Ya no me está preguntando como de la próxima semana, sino que una rutina. Entonces, acá ya no lleva ING, ¿ok? Es como la rutina. ¿Qué hacen todos los sábados? ¿Qué hacen todos los domingos? Entonces, para eso es necesario identificar cuál es cuál. The next one says, where are you going? Estamos hablando tal vez de mañana, next weekend, o ahorita, hey, where are you going? ¿Para dónde vas? ¿Para dónde vas? Right? So where are you going? So everybody, vamos a practicar, vamos a crear una conversación super short, okay, en grupos, y vamos a incluir estas preguntas con las respuestas, all right? So practice, practice. Remember, la primera, where, what are you doing tomorrow? Present continuous. What do you do in the weekend? Simple present, no lleva ing. Where are you going? Si lleva, lleva ing. I am going to a party. I'm going to the store. Voy a comprar tortillas, okay? I am going to the store. I'm going to the school, etc. So, ¿estamos bien? Are we good? Ahorita que ustedes lo practiquen, van a darse cuenta de la diferencia. And that's super important. Si tienen preguntas, recuérdense que hay un botoncito que dice pedir ayuda. You can call me and I'll be happy to help you. So let's go now. Everybody, let's join the groups, please. Let's get going. Let's get going. Let's go.
Mm-hmm. me pasó lo mismo, teacher. Estoy copiando las preguntas y ya no pude porque.
¿Y se le cerró?
No, ahí lo tengo, pero ya no pude copiar las preguntas porque está sobre la pantalla.
Vaya, si gusta.
Pero si, si lo trato de cambiar.
No se preocupe, acéptelo. Y ahorita voy y le muestro la pantalla en el grupo para que no la pierda. Okay. No se preocupe.
Está uh-huh. bien, está bien, gracias.
You are welcome. Hey guys, ¿me confirman si logran ver la invitación, please?
I don't see the invitation.
Fatima, tampoco. You don't have it.
No.
Okay, guys, háganme un enorme favor. ¿Ustedes ven la fotografía? ¿Ven su imagen?
Yes.
Okay, váyanse a los tres puntitos de la parte superior, porfa. De su imagen. Ven algo que se llama breakout okay. rooms.
Dice silenciar mi audio, detener video, renombrar, fijar el video. Ocultar vista propia.
No, ok. Wait, give me a second. So, no es esa. Hola, Miss. Sorry, yo creo que la mandé a otro lado. le acabo de dar la invitación. Deme un segundito, déjeme ver si la puedo enviar directo.
Ok.
I watch the jar. I go to the my job. I drive my car, and I prepare reports. In my job, I play soccer in the afternoon. That's it. And you, Silvia, where are you going?
I am going. Teacher, sí. Tengo duda.
Sí, it's correct.
I'm going or I am going?
¿Cuál fue la pregunta?
I am going. I am. Where are you going?
Yes.
I am going.
I am going to the beach.
You are going to the beach. Really? Nice.
Es una simulación.
Los engañé.
Milagros, what do you do?
Hola, Miss. No pudo, right?
Hello.
Hello.
No. No me sale nada.
Vaya, Miss, hagamos una cosa, creo que es lo más fácil. Si gusta, desconéctese un segundito y vuelve a entrar. Porque algo pasó con el pop-up.
Me meto como con el correo, nombre y todo. Como me meto siempre.
Sí, sí, exacto. Solo como rapidito salga y vuelve a entrar, vuelve a loguearse. O déjeme ver, okay. Porque no le aparece nada en la pantalla. Like, you don't see anything there.
No.
Permítame, déjeme ver si encuentro otra forma para que no salga. Hold on, hold on. Déjeme revisar, hold on. Vaya, Miss, le acabo de mandar la invitación. Si no le parece, revise en la parte de más, porfa, en la parte del menú de abajo.
¿Qué me tiene que salir, teacher?
Revisa si le aparece como breakout rooms, algo con rooms.
No. Participar, chatear, compartir pantalla, grabar, selección de grupos, reacciones.
¿Y la selección salir? De grupos.
Sesión de grupo pequeño, uno, le doy ahí.
Sí, ahí, yes, esa es.
Ok.
And you, what do you you going, Edith?
Where are you going? I go.
Where are you going?
In this
ventana. Y cuando estoy de turno de día, llego a casa temprano, me reposo y me dan ganas de bailar.
Ah, nice.
Me gusta practicar lo que es baile zumba.
Oh.
Richard, yo estoy hablando en español porque todo eso no sé cómo se dice en inglés.
Dancing zumba.
But I
dancing zumba.
Yes, I like dancing zumba. Zumba samba.
Richard, that's a question.
Yes, tell me.
That in the question the we are you
I like your panda, sorry.
Change
the panda.
Yeah.
You
change? I am Kung Fu Panda.
Yeah.
el going for doing. O sea, en la question is what are you doing? Y next complement the sentence and the question. That's it.
Sorry, I didn't get it. La pregunta es con what
are... ¿qué estás haciendo en este momento?
Pero creo que dice what are you doing tomorrow? No.
No.
Where are you going? Pero si se revisa dice where, y where no uh-huh. es el qué, sino a dónde. So where are you going? Por ejemplo,
vas?
Veo a mi hermano que va saliendo, hey, where are you going? ¿A dónde vas? Ajá. Uh-huh. Usted le puede ser más específico, where are you going on Monday? Where are you going on Saturday? Usted le puede incluir cuándo, ajá, no hay problema.
Ajá. No, esa era mi duda. O sea, lo que cambia es el where.
Sí, recordemos que podemos incluir, por ejemplo, dónde, cuándo, cómo, sí, la respuesta va a cambiar. La pregunta es where, ¿a dónde?
Thanks. Esa era mi question.
Y la respuesta sería I am going. Y ahí yes. Se pone el lugar, ¿verdad?
Exactly. I'm like, no voy a ningún lado. I'm not going anywhere. So no voy a ningún lado. Or I am going to the park. Yes. Esa sería la respuesta.
O sea, si le pregunto, por ejemplo, a Ávila en where are you going dance?
Okay, where are you going to dance? ¿A dónde va a bailar, verdad? Yeah. Where are you going to dance? Uh-huh. Yes, that's a good question.
Where are you going to dance, Abilene?
In my house.
Nice.
Oh, mm-hmm. Okay.
En mi casa. ¿Cómo?
Ajá, llega. Uy, go.
Cambiemos de tema.
You are terrible, guys. No, come on, continue.
Okay, ¿qué estamos? What do you do the next weekend?
Así en el what do you do?
Ajá.
What do you do the weekend?
Uh-huh. I check my email. ¿Cómo se dice? Reviso mis emails.
Check my mails.
No, ajá, pero reviso sería I check my mail porque asigno las ¿cómo es? Asigno las rutas de lunes. Entonces no sé cómo redactar eso. Que yo los fines de semana leo en la semana leo los emails porque así hago las rutas de transporte. Entonces, no sé cómo traducirlo. Quiero decir, el traductor me ayuda.
se puede decir arrange, no, es como concertar, no, eso no. No,
podríamos no, usar
que... organize root. ¿Cómo?
Yeah, maybe I read on Saturday because on Monday I organize routes, or because on Monday I organize the itinerary, o algo similar, ¿verdad? I mean, no tiene que ser como literal.
Organize meeting.
I organize meetings also.
Yes. So I check my email because organize meeting.
Yeah, that can be. That can be. Thank you. Yes. Thank you. Más fácil. Easier.
Es que en español tenemos como un millón de formas para expresar una idea.
En inglés también. Quizás no exactamente literal como en español, but la cuestión es encontrarle la forma, como usted lo acaba de hacer. That's the best way.
Mm-hmm. Lo mejor es pensar en inglés.
Ay, ese es
yes. Yes, pero eso se logra con constancia, con tiempo, con práctica. Así que baby steps right now. No worries.
Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Nice week, guys. Ya terminamos, teacher.
Oh, don't worry. I'm just like coming to check si necesitan ayuda.
¿Lo hacemos? ¿Quiere que lo hagamos?
Oh, please. If you are ready, okay. Sure. I would like to listen to you.
Okay. A ver si no me sale, Miss.
Es que se sale el internet, le falla y se sale de vez en cuando.
Vaya,
si entonces, no lo está como los lo chiquitos llamamos. De mi clase. No, está como los chiquitos de mi clase que dice, me salió, Miss, me salió. Ok. Hi, Doris. Hi, Doris, Luz, and Francisco. What are you doing tomorrow, guys?
Hi, Sandra. Tomorrow, I'm taking my breakfast with my co-worker.
Hi, Sandra. I am going tomorrow to work and check my email. I process documents.
Hi, Sandra. I am waking up early because I have sent emails.
And me, tomorrow, I am assisting a student in the class.
Okay. And Francisco, what do you do in the weekend?
I am going to the beach. And you, Luz?
I go to visit family. And you, Sandra?
I go to supermarket at 8 a.m.
Hi, Francisco. Where are you going?
I am going to visit my mom. And where are you going, Luz?
I going to my town. And you, Doris?
I am going to the Jardín Botánico with my friend.
I
and
love
you,
that place.
Sandra, where are you?
I am going to my father's house next week, guys. Thank you.
Perfect.
Nice. That was very good. Very good job. So your vocabulary was nice, guys. I like it. Very fluent and very natural. Que eso es lo que vamos buscando, hacerlo más natural every single day. No viene de leyendo, así que very nice. That was good. I love Jardín Botánico. That's good. Yes. Luz, ¿cuál es su hometown? What is your town?
Guatajiagua.
Oh my goodness, where is that? ¿A dónde está eso? Where is that?
Eh, quer, queda en Morazán, adelante Chapultepec. Wow. Y es el pueblo originario donde hacen todo lo que es el barro.
El barro negro, ¿verdad?
¡Wow!
El barro negro, ajá.
Guatajiagua. Nice. But it's far away. ¿Cuántas horas se lleva?
Hace poco fuimos el sábado y resulta que nos tardamos como 4 horas para ir y 4 para regresar.
One full day.
Generalmente son 2 horas.
Wow. 2 horas. But, yeah, four hours. My goodness, it's a lot. So son en el día 8 horas, 8 hours traveling. Wow.
Están construyendo. Entonces,
la carretera.
Sí. Hay como 3 construcciones, 3 reparaciones de calle ahorita.
Ay, por eso le toma más tiempo ir. Mm-hmm. But nice. I'm so happy. No sabía que hacían barro en esa zona or that place.
Mi familia lo hace.
Es el único lugar donde hace el barro negro, ¿verdad, Luz?
Wow. And what about you, Luz?
Y lo bonito es
que
tiene plomo.
¿No tiene plomo?
No.
No es dañino para la salud.
Bien bonito cuando uno ve, cuando ellos le llaman, están levantando, cuando ellos están monteando, porque todo lo hacen a mano. Las flores también lo van haciendo.
Wow.
A mano. Todo.
And what about you? ¿Puede hacerlo? Can you do it?
Yo no.
Pero la familia.
Toda la familia hace eso, todo. Hacen cántaros.
Nice.
Debería de tomar videos, Luz. Ahí me puede
yes,
servir.
Yes, that would be super. Yes, exactly. That would be super nice.
Sí, y si me lo permiten también, me gustaría entregarles a cada uno. Lástima que todo es virtual, pero sí me gustaría entregarles. Porque siempre que voy, me
encanta. Ay, reunámonos.
Sí, voy
al jardín botánico. Ay, sí, en el jardín botánico. I love that place. Yeah, yo sé, lastimosamente estamos como bien lejos, you know, we're far, far away, pero podríamos hacerlo. We could definitely do it. That would be super nice. I mean, creo que es parte de nuestro patrimonio. Me siento, ay, se acaba de ir Francisco.
Me salió.
Sí, se salió. Yeah, you know, me siento como yo y las pupusas. My family can make pupusas, but not me. Hey, Francisco, you're back.
Okay, que, por ejemplo, si inglés comprobativo en las oficinas están en el centro o algo por ahí, ir a dejar ahí unos presentes para cada uno de ustedes y cada quien que se encargue de irlo a retirar.
Ah, eso sería genial, aunque no sé si están funcionando. Ya vamos a ver cómo nos organizamos, pero sería super nice, that would be super.
Usted
super
no nice. Se preocupe, Luz. Que
por eso nos hacemos cargo. Mire que ya estaban organizando hasta una party with Andrés yesterday and everything. Okay, everybody, volvamos. Let's go back. Nice talking to you guys. That was good.
Thank you.
Hello, welcome back. Solo esperamos que se une el resto. Hold on. Okay, everybody. So everybody is coming back. Thank you very much. Ya casi terminamos, chicos. 8 minutes. We are almost done. So no he sentido honestamente 2 days. No he sentido las 2 horas. All right, guys. So I need your help. I know you were practicing part of this conversation with simple present, present continuous. And I would like to know if I have volunteers. Any volunteer who would like to participate? Cesar, thank you very much. I know you wanted to volunteer. So Cesar's group, let's be first.
Hey, guys. Hey.
My group hey, guys. It's Madeline, it's Jennifer, and Edith.
Okay, we are starting.
Okay, ready?
Hey, guys.
Hello, Madeline.
Hi, Madeline.
Hello, everybody. Hey, Madeline. What are you doing tomorrow? Can
you hear? I am going to my work tomorrow. And you, Jennifer?
Jennifer?
Jennifer is mute.
Maybe she has internet issues. Yeah, let's
go. Sorry.
There she is.
I'm here.
Okay, Jennifer.
You, Jennifer, what are you doing tomorrow?
I go to work early to my work. And you, Edith, what are you doing tomorrow?
Tomorrow, I playing with my son in the park. And you, Cesar?
I am resting in my house. Tomorrow is my free day.
Good.
Hey, Jennifer, what do you do in the weekend?
I go to work in the morning. In the afternoon, I stay in my house and play with my daughter. And Sunday, I go to church. And you, Madeline, what do you doing in the weekend?
I am go to the gym and I go to the mall. And you, Edith, what do you do in the weekend?
I go to the beach with my family and one day relax. And you, Cesar, what do you doing the weekend?
Me, on Saturday, I go to my parents' house. Then, the Sunday, I watch TV all day. And Madeline, where are you going in this moment?
I am going to the party.
Really?
Where are you going right now, Jennifer?
I go to cinema with my daughter. And you, Edith, where are you going?
I going to the supermarket. And Cesar, where are you going now?
I am going with Madeline with the party.
Really? Come on, Cesar, let's go.
Let's go.
Nice, that was super good. Thank you, guys. Very nice job. Hey, invite us, please. Take us to the party as well. That was very good. Good use of vocabulary, good pronunciation. Excellent. I like it a lot. And yeah, that was pretty good. So, Cesar, I let you choose. Seleccione uno más. Select one more, please.
Francisco.
The Francisco's group. That was, let me see, Sandra, that was Luz, and who was the other person? My goodness.
Okay. Hi, Doris, Francisco, and Luz. What are you doing tomorrow, guys? In Hi. Mute.
I'm sorry. Hi, Sandra. Hi. I am taking my breakfast with my co-workers.
I am waking up early because I have sent emails.
I going to work and I check my email and process documents.
Oh, perfect.
Me tomorrow, I am a system student in the class.
Okay. Francisco, what do you do in the weekend?
I'm going to the beach.
I go to the visit family.
I go to supermarket at 8 a.m.
Sandra, where are you going?
I go in my father's house. And you, Luz?
I go to my town. And you, Francisco?
I am going to visit my mom.
And you, Doris?
I'm going to Jardín Botánico with my friend.
Oh, okay. Nice week, guys.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Super good. Thank you very much. Okay, everybody. That was very good. So you talk about the places where you are going. Hablamos de la rutina super bien. Hablamos de los planes a futuro también using present continuous. I think you got it all. That was super good. So I don't know if you have like any question in the meantime, cómo utilizar simple present, present continuous. Un grupo por ahí tenía una pregunta, but no me recuerdo cuál era. I don't remember what was the question about present simple and continuous. Do you have any? Or are you like super good with this? No questions, guys. So if no questions, solamente like a little reminder. No sé si ya revisaron el grupo. Tenemos programados one-on-one today con algunos. Ahí está por ahí. Ya nos vamos a la otra meeting. So tengo primero el día de ahora a Francisco Eduardo a las 10. Sandra Beatriz después. Luego tengo a Gerson. Tengo a Madeline y Vero, sorry Vero, ustedes me la programaron de 10:40 a 10:50. Tenemos asignados 10 minutitos solamente para revisar cualquier tema que necesiten, igual para verlo de feedback, algún tema que se les está dificultando. Yo sé que este tema se confunde un poquito y a veces no encontramos cómo utilizarlo. So I will be like seeing you in a couple of minutes. Sister, no sé si tiene pregunta. I saw your hand up. No, sister. Edith, are we good?
No.
Okay, everybody, so in that case, have a wonderful night. See you tomorrow. Enjoy it. And ayúdenme con la tarea, please. And see you. Bye-bye.
Good night.
Bye-bye.
Good night.
Good night.
Miss, entonces, solo una duda. ¿Me conectaría a esa hora?
Sí, Miss. A menos que haya un cambio, a menos que alguien no entre porque por el internet o tenga una situación súper, súper necesaria por la cual no se pudo conectar, yo le escribo para que usted lo tome antes, oiga. Thank you. Yes.
A usted.